The ideas are really easy. Ideas always are very easy. I've always believed, I know it sounds a bit silly, that we all have in our heads the ability to be very, very strange with our ideas. And the worst thing about that is only that as we grow up, people tell us off for it. People tell us that we shouldn't be so silly. It's a very, very silly program. It's a science fiction show, sort of, in which the science makes no sense whatsoever, in which the lead character travels around in a spaceship which happens to be a small blue box, and only because the BBC couldn't afford a proper spaceship.
So, what is it? What's wrong?
I don't know, some kind of signal drawing the TARDIS off course.
The great thing about being a liar, who's a writer, is that you get the chance to lie and people are entertained in the process. It's the best form of lying there is, that you think up these really, really silly ideas and you want to tell people that they're true and no one tells you off for it. It's wonderful. I love being a liar and a writer. The thing about writing your own books and about writing theatre is you're actually God, and people don't interfere very much because there's not much money involved, really. When you move into TV and film, everybody has to have a say because there's so much riding on it. So I think quite rightly, it becomes something actually on which you are part of a sort of a big collaboration. That's what I'm thinking about. So, and that's the way that TV and film work. So I've been told by producers many times, you can't do that, think of something else. And they were almost always right. Not always, almost always. That's an important distinction. Sometimes they were very wrong.
I'm begging you, don't kill him, you didn't kill me.
Reading's vital to be a writer. I think that the only thing that we can do to keep ourselves sharp is to be reading constantly things that naturally seem to be what we want to read, but also things that we would never normally choose to read, and then you bounce off them. I think one of the great things about reading outside your comfort zone as well is that if I start ripping off, for example, Gustave Flaubert, which I do, no one ever notices because no one expects to find a link between my stuff and the writer of Madame Bovary. I think we can't control the way people think about us, and yes, there is a small part of me, I'll be honest, that kind of resents the fact, and I know it's a fact, that when I die, that my gravestone will have a Dalek on it, and all my other work, and the work I'm actually maybe prouder of, will probably never get remembered. But to be remembered at all is amazing.
Descending.